the functions of that. It is a normal procedure exhibition of the refrigerator. So inflation is very essential for it boosts the person. If there is no inflation at all, that is known as salubrious or reasonable inflation. That is known as moderate inflation, or it is always known as salubrious inflation. So if inflation is not there, then there are two other possibilities which are very worse than inflation. One is a zero inflation status. That is also not required. If inflation is not there, it will result in deflation. That is worse than this inflation. So a reasonable hike in the prices of goods or services, they are totally unavoidable. But whether it is healthy or not, that we have to take into proper account. So according to the calculation, both in the Arthashastra and in the modern pursuit, whenever there are two things. These things are common. Whatever you can invent newly, there are some things which are universal constants and commons, which we cannot just change at all. One is known as Svikriti. Svikriti means that is the demand. Vitarana means supply. So to give and take. Dana Svikarana, Dana Pratikraha, these things are the eternal dvandvas, eternal couplets. So whenever there is a demand and supply, that has an improportionate relation between each other. Yeah, even a basic commerce student can understand, 10th standard student can understand that there is inflation and there is going to be regularity. How to manipulate these things is known as the work of the government or work of the so-called technicians of economical construction or financial resurrection. That is the duty of these people. Is it known as government? Whenever a person in the society is suffering, who is imbalanced and who is also imbecile, not capable of constructing his own self, it is the duty of the responsible citizen or the organization of the state to reinstall the position of the person, at least for the basic amenities like food, education, medicine, etc. That is known as government. So government is a maternal organization. It does the work of a mother who shares the resources, enjoys the resources to be shared between the people with the subsidies, grants, aid, opportunities. Then various other processes are given by, so it is a motherly organization, this government, it has to do that. That's why I used to say, Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu need not be the statement of spiritual persons. Even those who are in trade and commerce, they have to say, Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. If there is some problem with the lorry owners and between the wages between the lorry operators, some there is a strike, then you cannot get any product delivered to you. Then totally it will disorganize the whole transportation system at all. So we have been forcefully made in such a situation that we have to daily utter Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu. Let Middle East be prosperous, due to which the oil flow and supply will be very perennial and conducive to us. Let US be prosperous so that the dollar economy be stable, so that the dependent economical institutions like IT, textile industry and export organizations be prosperous. So not only for us, that's why our ancestors, they have very much glorified Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu, which includes the bullion economy of UK, the dollar economy of US, and the fuel economy, the fossil fuel economy of Middle East. So Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu is very much essential practically and also conceptually for the members of stock exchange and share exchange, etc. So anybody involved in industrialization, trade and commerce, certainly they are interdependent in this globalization and privatization era. So apart from these, then we have to say there is one basic model of inflation that is known as a Robert model. Robert, who is a great economist, he classified this inflation into three major steps. One is, first is known as the cash pull. The second is known as the demand. And third is known as built-in. So the built-in, first we start with built-in. What is known as built-in inflation? Built-in inflation, it just explains the type of inflation which deals with the price and wages, which is within the workers, the industrial relations and the labor consent and cooperation. Then the democratic as well as the domestic factors of disorganized, unorganized or ill-organized relations between price and wages for the workers, as well as the relations between the management and the working constituents. Then it results in type of inflation which is very negligible. And the second thing is a demand pull. Whenever more expenditure is made, your expenditure that increases rapidly, unorganizedly, that creates that demand pull. So the second is the cash flow. Whenever a person with a product increases the prices, it is with the supply, not with the demand. Demand pull deals with the demand. That is, the more you spend, this deals with the more they offer, more they demand for the product. Now the present oil prices hike, that comes under cash flow. Demand flow comes whenever you are increasing ability for expenditure, lavish expenditure, multidimensional expenditure occurs and built in within the industrial relation. These things are the major issues. Now the government, you know that, see, there are a lot of things. It is known as a political knowledge game and gambling. Political knowledge is different from game. Political game is different from gambling. Now each and everybody, they comment or criticize the government that it is not controlling the inflation. If it would have been the other government, they have to face the same thing and they are going to do the same thing. And whatever they are going to do for balancing this thing, you see, it is known as hasty adjustment. What is it known as? Hasty adjustment. Whenever you are having an urge for money, a necessity for money, immediately you go for a hypervalent interest. You borrow from an unworthy person who is going to just crush your neck and not pay it. So we don't mind at the time of any necessity. So at the time of crisis, each and every government, not only for removing the crisis, but also to establish its own vote banks in the society, and also to reconsider, if the elections are in proximity, to reconsider the possibilities of their enthronement. So for political gaining and thronement, and also for getting the what we call janabhipraya or prajabhipraya, which is the concern of the wholesome public, they will do something without minding that it will create a very great inflation in the future. Everybody is going to do that because it is an unorganized structure of last two or three decades which cannot be immediately moved out. So there are few controlling measures as per the shastras. Whenever there is a sanchalana, achalana, we used to say. Sanchalana means that is hyperinflation. Achalana means that is inflation. Whenever these things occur in the society, there are some controlling measures. Number one, immediately what they can do is rate of interest will be increased. And new monetary policies will be implemented by the society. That is the second thing. And third thing is the wages and the prices that will go away. That will be very much increased. That also will be increased. Second is that is supply side economy. The real currency, along with the reference currency. What is the reference currency for us? That is gold. Gold and other valuables, they are known as reference currencies in economy, where the transaction between or exchange between this real currency and this other currency, reference currency, that will be fixed. And the other thing is new fiscal policy. Financial policy is different from fiscal policy. New fiscal policies, they will be implemented. Then recession will be to remove inflation. Then the two major things that they will do generally without no other way is increase of taxation and reducing expenses. If they increase taxation, then they'll say that the finance minister has increased and his vote will be very considerably reduced for the government. And whenever the expenses for the government regarding the health sector, agriculture sector, defense sector, if anything is reduced, and if it is reduced with the direct sectors like agriculture, animal husbandry, etc., immediately that will create a turmoil in the society. They will agitate. If it is in the defense, science and the technology and other things, the nation will stumble. So either they have to adopt these two things. They have to opt between only these two major things. One is to increase the taxation and to reduce the expenses. These are unavoidable things because either the policy or the budget or financial reforms are done only with the available resources. It carries the contributions of yester political communities. Natural resources and utility areas are utility percentage of our country. Number three, it also carries the blunders of the previous political parties and the rulings. So each and every political party, ruling party, carries such a resource which has usage, improper usage, limited usage, blunders, achievements and contributions. All of these things are totally carried by a government. Immediately one person cannot come and reform unless he is having the patra or a conjurer's wand by waving which he can create everything. He is not a magician. So this is a very never-ending story, and these type of things will have mutual impact. What is known as phenomenon of mutual impact. Somebody is glorifyingly, they are growing to a greater extent. Somebody, they have been trampled by insufficiency and paucity. So whenever these people who are squeezing the wealth and resources of the normal people, when they grow, this growth will affect on those people. They suffer. Their sufferings will also reflect upon this community. the grown community, established community, in the form of this Sensex and other fallings. So these type of things.